So epitaxy occurs if you flow the molecules in vacuum at very high temperature on a certain single crystalline substrate. Then your molecule, your atoms, supposed to follow the crystalline information of existing wafer and substrate at high temperature. So it's kind of like a copy-paste process. That is the conventional epitaxy process. Then what is remote epitaxy? Remote epitaxy is literally you perform the epitaxy in remote distance, meaning that if you have a wafer, you perform the remote epitaxy with certain distance where your atom still can feel the field from the underlying wafer. Even if there's some gap between the epitaxial film and the wafer. And how can you put down this gap between the wafer and the film? There's no way to do that. But we put down the graphene on top of the wafer. That way, you have just small gap between the film and the wafer. Then graphene, what's the role of graphene? We now know how to grow any types of materials on graphene on the wafer, meaning that we know how to copy paste crystal information of any types of wafer by using remote epitaxy. Then once you're done with remote epitaxy, you can peel off this replica of the wafer. And that wafer is super expensive. And technical impact of this technology is first, you can copy-paste expensive materials by using remote epitaxy. You can peel off, and this master graphene and the wafer now become kind of like apparatus, not the consumer wafer. So you keep replicating the crystal information. Imagine how, you know, we can save the cost of the material by doing so. So we can replicate gallium arsenide, indium phosphide, gallium nitride, complex oxide, or, you know, pricey materials. Not only that, if you replicate that, this material is not rigid anymore. If you replicate and peel off, this material becomes ultra flexible because it's ultra thin. Then this ultra thin flexible wafer can be used for many other applications. But one important killer application is the heterointegration of different materials. Meaning that you can put solar cell, you can put photodetector, you can put transistor in one place by just stacking them. You can stack any types of different types of devices in one place because this is thin, flexible form of crystalline. Previously, if you have just wafer like this, you cannot stack them up to make one device. Now, all different types of materials are in the single crystalline freestanding form. You can mix and match, you can stack them together to make the new functionality. So there are two important technical implications.